Hey everybody, it's your boy Dino Dean.
And the First Lady of Food, Miss Coretta.
And we're the Black Foodies.
Come join the Black Foodies for a culinary ride you'll never forget. As we travel coast to coast to show you some of the best cuisine around. Tasting and traveling, showcasing the restaurants you need to know about. And as we always say, we never turn down a great dish.
I'm just gonna dig right in.
And we rank restaurants off of kisses. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 being the best. So join us on our next foodie venture that we are about to start right now.
Guys, today we are in the Andersonville community here on Chicago's North Side, and the place is called Big Jones, and this is the creation of chef and owner Paul Fairbach. They have a southern themed menu, and guys, they have been just wowing the locals for years, and we're about to go in right now and let you guys see what it's all about. Ready, Miss Coretta?
You know I am.
Let's go get it.
Southern food. We're already a southern food restaurant, but we're highlighting gullet cuisine with such things as alligator pecan, which is alligator tenders with spicy tomato sauce, gumbo's herb, which is 7 different greens for good luck, okra, green hot sauce, spicy, comes with rice. Also, we're going to do boca negra, which is the best flourless chocolate cake you'll ever have, with a horchata sorbet. Our gumbo is a deep brew, the dark brew that you would only get, you know, in the depths.
Right, the south.
Yeah, in the depths.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And how long have you all been here?
Big Jones has been here 12 years. It's going on its 13th year, I believe, in April.
Okay, and then Restaurant Week runs through?
Restaurant Week starts today and runs through February 9th.
February 9th.
Yeah. So it's a 3-course dinner, appetizer, entree, and dessert. And then we have our regular fare as well.
So how would you describe Big Jones as far as the food?
As far as the food, like a flavor explosion.
Thank you, Chef.
Thank you so much. Thank you
for having us, and we'll see you guys in a minute.
Thank you.
I just love beautiful looking appetizers, and we're gonna start things off with these 3 huge prawns, and it comes with this remoulade sauce, and it's sitting on top of this little cabbage slaw. I can't wait to dig in. This looks absolutely spectacular. Let's take a look, guys. Hey. I'm just gonna pull the head off first. And I failed to mention these are chilled as well. Look how big these are. This is really, really on point, guys. It's like a shrimp cocktail on steroids. Very, very good. And this remoulade sauce, man, you better ask somebody. And I'm gonna try this slaw. I'm a sucker for a good slaw to have a little bit of this remoulade sauce in it. Spectacular. Nice, clean, fresh taste to it. It's not overcomplicated. And with this remoulade sauce, it just gives it a New Orleans flair. Guys, we're starting off with a bang.
Guys, we were brought out gumbo 2 ways. A total vegan gumbo, which I've never had, and also your traditional New Orleans gumbo with the dark, smoky root. So the first one I'm going to try is the vegan gumbo. And it has 11 different vegetables. It has collard greens, okra, all types of yumminess. Amazing. It's like eating a bowl of soul food gumbo. Yummy. And I'm gonna add the rice. So for you vegans, come try this. And I'm gonna move on to the traditional gumbo. Looks like it has the andouille sausage. And look at that dark roux. I am totally loving this. I mean, it's so smoky. Now this is tasty.
There's nothing more southern than some great fried chicken, guys. And y'all know I love that yard bird. I have a delectable looking plate of fried chicken, turnip greens, as well as their Hoppin' Johns. Man, I'm just gonna dig in right away. But I'm gonna start off with the turnip greens. Everybody does collards. Seems like the old turnip greens get kinda left by the wayside. Super good, hot. These turnip greens just scream down south. Word, this is really, really on point. I almost can say this is the perfect side. It's that good, wow. And right now, guys, we're gonna move on to these Hoppin' Johns. And as was explained to us, Hoppin' Johns comes from the Gullah Geechee culture over on the East Coast, right around Hilton Head, South Carolina. And instead of using black-eyed peas, Big Jones uses these red beans, and I'm about to check it out right now. This is so authentic and genuine. Very, very good. I think there's some okra in here as well. Wow, this is really, really delectable, guys. Southern food hasn't tasted this good in a very, very long time. This is how it's supposed to be done. And now on to the yard bird. I think I'm gonna start off with this leg. Have a look. I know y'all heard that crunch. Boy, they know what they're doing up in here. And Big Jones also has their own signature hot sauces, guys. And we're gonna try the pickle peach hot sauce. That's ingenious. And I'm gonna sprinkle a little bit of this on this yard bird. That's quite a bit. But let's give it a go. That is absolutely amazing. Go a little bit more. I love the sweetness of this hot sauce. Has a nice kick to it. Very balanced. It's not just gonna blow you out. Sweet, with a little bit of heat, and a whole lot of flavor. They also have another one called their jerk hot sauce. Try this one next. See what's up. Now, if you see me shooting flames, don't laugh. This is absolutely stunning. There's a smokiness to this. once again, it's not gonna blow you out with the heat, just enough to just linger on your palate just long enough to appreciate it. This is all good. Come on down to Big Jones and get you some of this here. And a good southern meal isn't complete without some cornbread. And I have this jalapeno cheddar cornbread, guys. Take a look at it. It just looks so wonderful. I'm just gonna dig into it. Just look at that. I love the caramelization on the outside. And it's smoking hot. So when you guys come, make sure you be careful because this little skillet is hot. See all that steam coming on? I'm about to give this a go. This is so moist and spectacular. And what I really love about it more than anything is the caramelization on the outside. It gives it a nice little crust, and then you dig inside just to some moist goodness. This is a superior cornbread, guys.
A Mardi Gras party is not a party without crawfish etouffee. So I'm going to try the Big Jones version of the crawfish etouffee. And it's Louisiana crawfish tails smothered in wine, butter, and onions with spices, served with their butter Delta rice. All right, let's give this a go. The first thing that hit me was the wine. And I love some wine. Let me add the rice to it. And these crawfish, nice juicy plump crawfish as well. I can't stop eating this. Eat with your eyes, and I can't take my eyes off of this dessert. It's called the Boca Negra. It's a dark chocolate chili cake, so it has a little spice to it. The Benny Almond Candy, Dulce de Leche Horchata Sorbet. I mean, look at that. And then the fruit is plum quartz, and it has a salted caramel sauce that it sits atop of. All right, I hate to go in on this dish. I mean, really, simply beautiful. So many textures going on, so many flavors. This caramel is everything. I'm going on this horchata sorbet because I love horchata drinks. So this is going to be a treat. Oh, wow. I'm telling you, it's flavorful. I mean, you got the right sweetness to it. Just everything is like just surprising me. The compotes, the caramel, the chocolate, the granola. I mean, really. It's like eating a variety of chocolates all on one plate. This will heighten your senses for real.
Guys, right now we're going to give you our recap on Big Jones, located here in Andersonville on the north side of Chicago. And as you guys know, our ranking system goes off of kisses, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 being the best. Ready, Miss Coretta?
Yeah, baby.
One kiss. Two kisses. Three kisses. Four kisses.
five kisses, guys. They are doing it big time here at Big Jones here in Andersonville. It is really, really an experience that you have to come check out. Everything was just Southern-licious, Southern authentic, and Southern good, guys. So make sure you come on out and check out Big Jones. It is a true staple here in this community.
And if you have a restaurant you would like for us to showcase, email us at theblackfoodies@gmail.com.
Theblackfoodies@gmail.com, guys. And make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel and also hit that notification bell so you can hang out with us wherever we go. But we're out of here, guys. A little bit chilly today. Late January, could be worse. But we got to head on back to the home front. One love, guys.
Bye.